Good evening to each and everyone present on this online platform. I, Dr. Kulinder Singh Ma, serving as faculty in physics department and coordinator of the DVT star college scheme of DAV College of Tinda. So I pray to the Almighty for her precious blessings for this event to be successful for all the participants. So before successful as well as useful too. Before the introduction of our worthy resource persons of this online workshop dedicated to develop computational skills of participants, I would like to thank all the resource persons, Principal Sir, HOD, and my colleagues for their consent and cooperation for arranging this workshop. I, on the behalf of DAV College Management Committee, staff, students, welcome all the participants, students, and faculty members for joining this interdisciplinary workshop arranged under the banner of DVT Star College Scheme by the Department of Physics. So I want to describe the overview of the workshop and objective of Star College Scheme in a short time. The overview of the workshop is keynote address by Professor P.K. Ahluwalia ji. So our resource persons are present, Dr. Ahluwalia ji, Dr. Sapna Sharma ji, and Dr. Smita Shahu ma'am is also present. Topics to be covered in this workshop: developing mathematical and computational thinking of science students. Beyond a simple worksheet, macros, users defined functions and subroutines. Under an undergraduate computational physics course, implementation using spreadsheets. Spreadsheets as a toolkit for science laboratories, data handling and error analysis, troubleshooter of physics, classical and quantum oscillators, hitting the bullseye, so let us calculate pi, that was demonstrated by using Monte Carlo approach. And about Star College Scheme, the Department of Biotechnology, DBT, Ministry of Science and Technology, Government of India has started Star College Scheme in the year 2008. It provides financial support to UG science students across the country for improving the practical training. Our college, DAV College Bathinda, is the only college of this region awarded by the scheme. And objectives of the scheme can be described with the acronym of the word SMART: S, strengthening of infrastructure for science labs; motivating students for hands-on practical training; augmentation of interdisciplinary activities; refinement and repair of existing lab equipments; training of students, teachers, and lab staff. So today's workshop is dedicated to the objective of the Star College Scheme. To achieve the objectives of DVT Star College Scheme, our team are putting their best efforts during the period of lockdown. We have arranged many online activities like webinars, poster making competitions, virtual labs, training, virtual tours, making ESOPs, set up of innovation hub for live demonstrations, creating journal club, and organized webinars on research journals, etc. So this workshop is very special and useful to all the participants to enhance their computational skills that are required for the lab or laboratories of the science. As per the recommendation of our advisory committee, from this platform, I would like to request all the esteemed DBT team members to organize future activities related to interdepartmental workshops, interdisciplinary projects, quiz competitions, research lab excursions, and efforts to provide practical science education. One humble request to all the participants that please keep yourself mute during the sessions and keep typing your questions in the chat box as well as on your notebooks and making your own notes too. You can clarify your queries and questions in the question answer session and timely complete the assignments given by the experts. This is a very important part. So the certificates will be provided to only those participants who complete it successfully. I mean, all those participants who are sincerely doing the homework. So for the assignments, we have created Google Classroom. So the link has already been provided in the flyer as well as the schedule. So you should join the Google Classroom. So now, without taking much time, I hand over the control to Dr. Gurpreet Singh, Head of Physics Department, for introducing our esteemed resource persons. Thank you. Over to Gurpreet Singh, sir.
Okay. Respected Principal, Professor Praveen Kumar Garg ji, my dear faculty members from the Department of Physics and from the other departments as well, and my dear students, good afternoon to all of you. It is a matter of pride and privilege for the Department of Physics that we have with us renowned academic personalities for 1 week workshop. The Department of Physics is extremely happy to organize this workshop on Microsoft Excel spreadsheet, a tool for enhancing mathematical and computational skills of UG students. Let me introduce to all of you that we have with us Dr. P.K. Aluwalia ji, Dr. Sapna Sharma, and Madam Sarmishta Sahu. And all of them will remain with you, the participants, for all of the 6 days. And I am sure that all of you will benefit from their knowledge and will definitely translate that information into your practicals performance in your labs. Now, it is an honor to introduce to you Honorable Dr. P.K. Aluwalia ji, who is a retired professor from Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla. During his stint as a teacher professor at the university, he remained associated with a number of assignments and responsibilities as coordinator SAP, as member of Himachal Pradesh State Higher Education Council, as Dean Faculty of Sciences, as Director IQAC, as member Academy Council of the university, to name a few. After his retirement, he is currently advisor of Bhara University as well as adjunct faculty at UGC Inter-University Accelerator Center at New Delhi. He has more than 120 research papers published in higher impact factor peer-reviewed journals, which have more than 1,275 research citations. He has been awarded Commonwealth Academic Fellowship at University of Edinburgh, UK. He has also been awarded Best Teacher and Academic Administrator by HP University for the year 2012. He has been awarded Environment Leadership Award 2017 in individual capacity by Department of Science and Technology, Government of Himachal Pradesh, Shimla. So he has a basic interest research in science popularization, radio feature writing, development of spoken tutorials, community surveys. He is currently working on developing e-resources for one of the MSc courses for UGC PG Parshala project. Thank you very much, sir, for accepting our invitation. We feel proud and honored to have you with us.
Thank you very much. Very good evening to everybody. Am I audible?
Excuse me, sir. I want to share information of other resource persons also. Let me give me 2-3 minutes more. We will also be having with us in the workshop Dr. Sapna Sharma during the workshop. She is an associate professor from St. Bede's College, Shimla. She is currently pursuing research in the field of physics education research. Her work mainly focuses on the understanding of conceptual difficulties of students studying physics at UG level through the development of appropriate diagnostic and assessment tools like concept inventories. Along with this, she has carried out extensive attitude surveys about physics using MPEX in the state of Himachal Pradesh. She has also created a clicker classroom environment for interaction with students during the delivery of content in physics classroom. She has also published research papers in journals of national and international repute. Thank you very much, madam, for accepting our invitation. We will also be having with us Dr. Sarmishta Sahu. I'm extremely happy and feeling proud that we have Madam Sarmishta Sahu, who is a well-known demonstrator of innovative experiment. She is a retired associate professor from Maharani Lakshmi Amani College, Bangalore. She is actively participating in IAPT activities also. She is a demonstrator as well as author of many volumes of books, namely Understanding Physics and Concise Physics. She has conducted innumerable workshops and hundreds of science demonstrations to her credit. She has remarkably designed and demonstrated science models with the demonstration. She is actively demonstrating various computational experiment scales on Microsoft Excel and has conducted various online demonstrations also. At last, I am hopeful that the participants of this workshop will definitely enhance their computational abilities during this workshop. Now I request our worthy principal, Professor Praveen Kumar Garg ji, to welcome our speakers.
Our distinguished keynote speaker of the first day on the 7-day online workshop, Dr. P.K. Ahluwalia, former professor, Department of Physics, HP University, Shimla. Dr. Sapna Sharma ji, associate professor, St. Bede's College, Shimla. Dr. Sarmista Shahu, retired associate professor from Bangalore and authority in the field of demonstration. Professor K.S. Mann, coordinator of STAR College scheme, faculty members of our college, teachers from other institutions, and dear students. Good evening to one and all present here on the inauguration of this DBT-sponsored online workshop. On behalf of management, staff, and students of DEB College Bathinda, I extend a warm welcome. Persons who have expertise in their fields, I am sure that their deliberations will enrich our knowledge in every sphere. I would like to use this opportunity to acknowledge the role of our science faculty, first for getting our college covered under DBT STAR College scheme, and secondly, for making all-out efforts to make this scheme a big success. There is hardly any week when I do not find some activity in the college under the DBT scheme. I am sure that the continuous efforts of our DBT team will bring laurels to our college. I would like to congratulate the Department of Physics under the leadership of Dr. Gurpreet Singh, Associate Professor and Head, for taking the big initiative for organizing this unique event, that is a workshop on MS Excel and spreadsheet as a tool for enhancing the mathematical and computation skills. I am pretty sure that this start by our resource persons in enriching the knowledge of our faculty as well as students. Such programs will satisfy the dire need of updating the faculty as well as students with latest development in the respective fields. I wish you all the success, all the best for this workshop. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving this very important words for the department. Now I request Dr. Ahluwalia to start the keynote address for the session. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. I am really pleased to be here with all of you this evening. I am grateful to Professor Praveen Garg ji, the principal of DAV College, Bathinda, that he has really led a team of very dedicated teachers on the campus to win this DVT STAR scheme. And I think I can say from my own interactions also that you have really inspired them to work hard, and that is why this program is here. I am also thankful to Professor Gurpreet Singh, the head of the department, physics, and Dr. Kulvinder ji, who has been, you know, asking me, though I'm a retired person, he really forced me to come. So that was very kind of him, that he thinks that retired people are also of some use. So thank you very much. I also, on my own behalf, welcome my other team participants, the resource persons, Dr. Sharmishta Shahu and Dr. Sapna Sharma. I am basically a catalyst, you know. They are the main participants in the reaction. So please pardon me if I really go here and there, and I'm not that good at what they are actually so good at doing all those things.
My role is, I was actually reading new education policy. Let me come to the point now. And in that education policy, it has been very clearly mentioned that an all-out effort needs to be made for developing mathematical and computational skills of the students. And when we are talking of computational skills, that doesn't mean that these are required only by physics students or by chemistry students or by math students or by computer science students. They are for everybody. If I go to an economics classroom, for example, I find that they also use the same kind of mathematics which we use in physics. There is not much of a difference. Maybe the context change. If I go to chemistry also, I find again they are using very similar things which we do, say, in a mathematics classroom. Even when I go to, say, a classroom like biology, I find that in today's digital era, biologists are the biggest users of computational skills. And they are not able to do without computational skills. Any course which has a component of, say, field work, and I think history people must be having that kind of a field work involved in their subject. Other social sciences people also, collect a lot of data from the field and would like to really look at that, what that data means. They will find that they are also supposed to learn these kinds of computational skills. If you look at Nobel Prizes, which are being given these days, I remember last year a Nobel Prize in economics was given, and Professor Abhijit was, I think I am taking the right name, was given that award. What he has done, he has collected data and analyzed it, and he has given a new dimension to extracting a lot of useful information from that kind of a data by using computational skills only by his team. And he has a lot of, labs in our country also. In Gujarat, he has worked. He has worked in many other countries also to look at how the social status of the common man can be improved as far as his or her economic conditions are concerned. So please do remember that when we are talking of this kind of a workshop, this may look as if we are going to talk about physics, but it is applicable to almost all the areas of physics. If I may put it like this, you will find that the three resource persons who are part of this program, if I talk about Dr. Sapna Sharma, she is going to really help us know where the lab skills actually come and how those lab skills can be enhanced by these computational skills itself. Visualization, for example, how usefully it can be done, how we can really gather data and process it, how we can really look at various approximations involved. When I look at Professor Sharmishtha's lectures, I find she is going to present wonderful case studies of modelings. And that modeling is not necessarily, relevant for physics. That is relevant for any other area of study. It may be chemistry, maybe biology, wherever, you will find that some kind of model needs to be made. All these skills actually come into picture. What I will try to do is I will just go to my presentation. I'll take a minute to reach there and talk about a few things which are very crucial for understanding what I am trying to say, actually. I hope you will see the screen in a minute. Can you see my presentation, please?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So let us go to the presentation itself and start understanding it. The title of this small presentation is Developing Mathematical and Computational Thinking Among Science Students, and not necessarily for physics students. But I can replace this science taught by physics, I can replace it by chemistry, I can replace it by biology, and you will find that this will apply. The example which I am going to take in this particular presentation, that is not from physics at all. It's from what you call a study of demography. And we talk about such things there also. So the workshop objectives are very clear in our mind. We want that participants should be able to appreciate the importance of mathematical and computational thinking. Computation as a third way of doing science. Understand the role numerical methods play in setting up of physical problems or solutions on a computer. write down an algorithm or problem at hand, able to visualize the numbers crunched out by the computer to make an intuitive and physical sense out of those, and check whether the results are physically correct or not. Implement the knowledge and skills to a given statement of the problem or project. And what I am assuming is that in all the lectures, you will find you don't require knowledge of science more than at the plus two and first year level. What we will be doing, we will be doing coding in spreadsheets. Now, there are very interesting thoughts which must be coming in the minds of participants. Why spreadsheets? Why not in Python? Why not in Fortran? Why not in C? Why not in C++? Definitely, you can use those also. We are not against those kinds of skills. Let me tell you my own experience as a teacher who was very much interested in introducing computational skills right from 1992, the time which I am actually telling you. It is over the last 30 years that at Shimla, we have been working on this particular idea itself. And we were one of the first set of people in the country who brought out a book on computational physics itself in the year 1997. It's almost 23 years old idea which I am sharing with you. But at that time, we didn't have that kind of a reach which today we have. And, you know, when we were designing a syllabus for introduction of these kinds of skills, what we were finding that there were some, you know, blocks which were there in reaching out up to the subject which we wanted to teach. For example, I want to teach physics only. But then if I want to teach that, I was finding that whole of the semester I'm spending in teaching them a programming language itself. And by the time I reached the end of the semester, I was always, you know, feeling harassed and very dissatisfied that I have not been able to, you know, touch the problems which I wanted to do with the students. And that was the reason that we discovered the beauty of these spreadsheets. And that is what we are going to explore with you in the workshop. There is another very interesting set of learning outcomes which are going to come out of this workshop. You will be able to appreciate the place of computational methodology in the study and research of science. Physics, chemistry, mathematics, you can add geography, you can add economics, you can add any other subject, history, social sciences, political science, sociology, you name anything and you will find that it will fit in this area. Vis-a-vis traditional ways of doing these sciences. For example, in the case of physics, we know that we can do physics in two ways traditionally. One is that we do experiments and draw some conclusions from there. When Kepler actually gave us the three laws of planetary motion, he actually drew his conclusions from a huge set of data collected over a period of 30 years by Tycho Brahe. So that was one way. And people used to do experiments. Galileo did experiments. And after that, we know there is a complete story of the experiments which we have done in physics, and that has changed the face of the world today. You will also learn how to formulate a physical problem for solution and compute. You will be able to visualize the role of mathematical modeling and numerical methods in the study of computational physics or computational science. And to make you understand the methodology of modeling using a mundane problem, I'll pick up a problem and try to see how I can formulate that problem. You'll be able to identify inherent characteristics of numerical computing and their importance by writing small, small spreadsheets. And you will be able to get an overview of computing environment and the choice of programming language needed for doing physics. And I think the first very good way of introducing computational skills among students is via spreadsheets. There is a reason also, because these spreadsheets are available almost on every computer which we touch in the form of, say, Excel spreadsheet, or maybe in OpenOffice, the spreadsheet is also available as an open source software. So I think it will be really interesting to really look at that. For this workshop, I would like to suggest one book also, which if you get, it is of just 200 rupees. You will be, you know, running on the Excel sheets. And the title of the book is Mathematical Modeling with Excel. Don't get scared by the word mathematical. This is something which is desirable whenever you have to go on a computer. Actually, you have to translate something in the form of some kind of a mathematical model. And then and only then you can really appreciate it when it comes to the computation part itself. And it reminds me a very famous quotation of a Nobel laureate in physics. I think he is one of the great teachers of physics also.
He has written an excellent set of 3 volumes, Lectures on Physics by Richard Feynman. And he also was a man who was very much into computation. If you read those lectures, you will find at some stage, he starts introducing the numerical method of solving the problems. And that was in the 60s. Please do remember, that was the time when only mainframe computers were available. So what he was suggesting to the students in those lectures was, take a calculator and try to see what you can do numerically as far as solution of a typical problem in physics is concerned. And he made a beautiful statement. And that statement actually distinguishes between computer science and the sciences. Though he was talking in the context of physics, but this is in fact relevant in the context of all other sciences. So he says computer science differs from physics in that it is not actually a science, because it doesn't study natural objects. Neither it is, as you might think, mathematics, although it does use mathematical reasoning quite extensively. Rather, computer science is like engineering. It is all about getting something to do with something rather than just dealing with abstractions. So when you want to really see what is the implication of a theory which somebody has propounded, you would like to do those numerical calculations to see what are the results and whether they match with the physical reality or not. There was one other very interesting statement which Feynman made. And I think that's so beautiful statement that you will see the beauty of that statement throughout this particular workshop itself. He used to say, similar equations, similar solutions. And I will show you in this particular presentation itself that what did he mean. And when I will translate that idea from, say, population study to physics itself. So please do keep in mind the wisdom of this great man. So please try to see how we do physics, as I mentioned. We have now added a third way of doing physics. We have experimental way, we have theoretical way, and we have a computational way of doing physics. Today, there are certain branches of physics. They cannot really give us the kind of conclusions we know today, the kind of inferences which we know today, the kind of understanding which we have today without computational effort. To name a few, chaos is one such field which actually people started appreciating and understanding when they started doing computations. If you go to weather forecasting, you will find you cannot really do weather forecasting without mathematical modeling and the use of computational methodology. So today we are actually talking of this computational physics, not only for, you know, just supplementing experimental and theoretical physics, but we are talking of using it for telling experimentalists that, look, I have predicted this kind of a material which is possible, or this kind of a drug which is possible. Would you like to go and try to synthesize this drug now? Because I'm sure the laws of physics or laws of chemistry are telling me that such a drug should exist. So that is the kind of, you know, excitement which is there in enhancing our skills as far as computation is concerned. So if I look at, say, computer science, it is all hardware and software. And what am I going to do on that? I'm going to, you know, apply these resources to study certain applications by making use of some mathematical tricks or numerical techniques. And there are very few such numerical techniques, let me tell you. I wish if we can introduce these numerical techniques right in the first year of the college study itself, so that people start exploring these kinds of skills as they progress in this in their particular area of study itself. There are some very interesting links in this presentation. I would definitely give this presentation to Professor Mann to host it on the classroom, Google Classroom, so that you can really click these and see what these particular links actually tell us. Now, let me come to the workshop's methodology. During the course of this workshop, you will be shown some exercises via following process using spreadsheets. One is formulation of the problem. This is the most crucial thing. I remember when I was actually doing my PhD, I was supposed to do some computation. And at that time, the nearest computer which was available was at Regional Computing Center, RCC people used to call it, at Chandigarh. So we were supposed to go there, write our programs, and rather seek the help of the programmer there also, that, okay, I have done it rightly. Then, you know, punch the cards, put that stack in the computer and then run the program. And maybe we will come to know that, oh, this program has not run. There is some problem with it. So go on a process of debugging. We are out of all those things. The only thing is that let us focus on the formulation of the problem. Maybe try to identify what numerical method we can apply. Then sit down and design a worksheet. Once you are able to put things in the worksheet, you will find that the worksheet offers you a very interesting way of visualization also. And once you get the results, I think we can open up many avenues for discussion, some kind of critique, how we can improve it, how can we go ahead. And maybe this can also offer us a possibility of doing certain problem which we would like to really explore. Maybe my analytical methodology being followed on the blackboard doesn't allow me to really explore those kinds of problems. For example, I ask myself a question. If Newton's law of universal gravitation had not been 1 upon r square, but had it been 1 upon r cube, what would have been the results? Would we have found the solar system the way we are today like that only, or there would have been something else? Maybe all of the universe will look something different when we bring in that kind of a law. So you are supposed to use your spreadsheet to explore such possibilities. And once you are comfortable with a small spreadsheet, I think a time will come when you can switch over to the best possible languages available to us. Spreadsheets actually offer us a kind of a middle path. Please do remember that. So it is a four-step process. One is formulation of an appropriate mathematical model. Now, this is where the mathematical thinking part comes into play. Choosing an appropriate numerical method. What kind of method we need to apply? Implementation of method approach to arrive at a solution. How do we do that? And the validation of a solution. Let me just show you a few things here. Which can be very easily appreciated. It in fact involves number of considerations. One is identification of the problem and formulating its statement. So if the statement is properly formulated, I think everything else will follow. There will not be much of a difficulty with that. And that is one of the reasons that we are trying to talk about all these things. Then identify important variables. Then identification of physical law or laws governing the problem leading to relationship between variables in the form of mathematical equations. Assumptions and approximations involved in arriving at the model. And identification of critical features as essential elements itself. Now, let me just try to see whether I can really show you something. I hope this whiteboard is visible to everybody. I am writing one very simple equation from physics. And this equation is basically this. S is equal to half a t square. Now we start studying this equation from high school. Maybe sometimes people may say, sir, you should have added plus ut also, but I have deliberately kept it like this. Now let me try to see it in the form of a mathematical model itself. I am told a very simple information that I'm supposed to find the distance of a particle traveling on, say, a line. And this particle is accelerating. So if I am told this, that it is accelerating, that means I am being told that d2s by dt square is equal to some acceleration. Now what I have written actually here is nothing but an equation of motion. And if I insert this, you will find that if you integrate it twice, you will be able to get the same result. You know what has happened? I do this in class 10 or 11 also, but in going from that approach to this approach of calculus brings in a lot of mathematical, what you call, abstraction. Okay, and when we are actually talking of calculus, that means, say, change of a function with respect to some variable involved in that, we are asking a very simple question, and we are saying, please tell me, if I change the value of this variable by a small amount, how much this f will change? Say, I change this variable by a small amount, I calculate the new value of this function, and subtract from it the old value, by what amount it has changed, and what is the rate of that change, that is with respect to this delta t. And then you start bringing these limits, delta t approaching zero, and it becomes a very, very abstract way of looking at the things. This is one of the difficulties which students encounter as they try to learn these things. But now try to see that this kind of an equation, which I wrote here, you can encounter when a body is falling. Let me just let a body fall. This is y-axis, and this is, say, a body which is falling. Now, it is falling under the action of the gravity. And there is an acceleration which is generated in this body called acceleration due to gravity. Now, I can suddenly, from a body moving on a road with an acceleration A, get a similar equation here, which is this, that d2y by dt squared is equal to g. And its solution will be this, y is equal to half gt squared. So I said, this is one kind of an equation. This is another kind of an equation. Equations were similar, and we were able to arrive at the result. So this is what is the meaning of similar equations, similar solutions. And when I look at this definition of the derivative, what I find is that this definition actually is nothing but a definition of differences. What I have done, in the numerator, there is a difference which is written. In the denominator also, there is a difference which is written. This is not delta t, this is only t. Okay, so this is nothing but, derivatives is nothing but involving difference equations. Let me go to economics class. Somebody will ask, okay, today I invest some money. Amount of money invested is at time t equal to mt. After time t plus delta t, say after 2 years, what will be this money equal to? So what is the person asking? The person is asking, please tell me, what is the rate of growth of my money? So if I write it like this, minus, say, m at time t and divide it by delta t, I'm basically doing something which I did in physics to explain this. And somebody will say, okay, what do you mean by this? I will say, this is rate of growth of the money. How is money growing? And, we understand it in our common language as the growth of money in terms of the rate of interest itself. Okay, per year, this much interest you will get. That is how I decide about this difference which is sitting in the numerator itself. Now, all these problems can be computationally solved on the computer itself. And that was my, contention which I wanted to tell you. So, once we know this methodology, I think we are in a very simple position to go ahead with just for a minute, please. Yeah. With our, solutions. Now, let me just tell you a list of equations which you will find in chemistry, in biology, in physics, in economics, in geography. Sometimes you will find that people are going to deal with just algebraic equations, linear or nonlinear. Sometimes you will find they will be dealing with polynomial equations like, ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Sometimes you will find they are going to deal with transcendental equations involving trigonometric or exponential or logarithmic functions. The one equation which I will just demonstrate here, you will find ultimately it turns out to be nothing but an exponential function itself. Then I just wrote two equations. What were those two equations? Differential equations. Ordinary or partial, depends on whether you are working in one dimension or two dimensions or in three dimensions or maybe in four dimensions. Then the integral equations. Now, these are the sets of equations which you will get. If you know how to solve these, the numerical methods involved will always be applicable in different situations. You don't need to worry that, this numerical method was being used in physics only, so maybe can I apply it in biology or can I apply it in economics? You can. Without doubt, you can apply that. Because do remember, similar equations, similar solutions. So once the mathematical model is placed, we can ask ourselves a few questions. And that is, can I follow some analytical approach to solve this model? If yes, get the solution, no problem. And that is what we do on the blackboard. If no, then think about computational approach. Till almost, the beginning of the 20th century, most of the time people were making mathematical models which we could solve with the help of a pen and paper. We could sit down and solve it.
Newton, Einstein, you name a few people, you will find they were very good in these kinds of analytical skills. They had wonderful analytical skills. And if I may put it as mathematical skills, that will be more appropriate. But today I am talking of 21st century, where I'm finding I have a very interesting tool where I can really try to solve these problems, howsoever complex they may be. Introduction of the complexity becomes very easy. So what we do is, if we have to apply the computational approach, we have to look for an appropriate numerical method or approach to solve the problem. It may be finding the root of an equation, or numerical differentiation, or numerical integration, or Monte Carlo approach, or solving a set of linear equations. And a problem can be solved not in just one way, it can be solved in more than one ways. So somebody may say, I would like to follow this kind of a path. Somebody else may say, no, I would like to really follow another kind of a path. And a methodology actually emerges out of this. And this is a process which emerges of for computational approach. So what we do is, once we are, into what we call this problem statement, we try to convert it into mathematical model by using some mathematical concepts. And fortunately or unfortunately, people like Newton or people like Einstein, they not only, formulated their problems, they also discovered that mathematics which was needed for making the model itself. And then, now I am saying, instead of applying analytical approach, let us try to apply numerical method. And then implement it and see whether your solution is obtained or not. For implementation, what do you require? You require hardware and software. Today, my mobile is far more capable of the kind of computer which I had as my first computer. I had just 4 MB of RAM and 40 MB of hard disk. My mobile today has got a memory of about 128 GB. Imagine, it is huge memory. Once you have this solution, there is one very interesting possibility. Go for its validity. If your solution turns out to be valid, you are very happy. If you are finding that it is not valid, so you try to see, where should I really try to make a change? Do I need to change my model itself? Do I need to change the method itself? Do I need to improve the algorithm for implementing it on the computer, or it will work otherwise? So you have, this kind of an approach, which is like, feedback approach, where you keep on asking questions and see how you can make the improvements. So maybe sometimes I'm very happy with a solution which is correct up to first decimal place. But sometimes I may not be very happy with that. I would like that my solution should be correct up to, say, fourth or fifth or sixth or eighth decimal place. Some people who are sitting in this lecture may have been doing computations using, say, Fortran or C or C++. They know what is the meaning of precision. Single precision and double precision. When do we want to use single precision calculations, and when do we want to use double precision calculations? So when we have problem statement, we have formulated it. So what I'll do is I will try to apply it to study the population growth of a city. I picked up this problem because this problem is applicable in very many contexts. One context is the context through which we are passing these days. How epidemics spread. And epidemics spread in a very similar fashion, the way population grows. So I try to find out what is going to be my starting assumption or law. So now try to see how I have identified a problem statement, and I'm trying to see what is the law involved. And that law involved is very simple. More people living, more births will be there. More people living, more deaths are going to be there. So birth and death rates are directly proportional to the population. So my model is in place. I know what law I have to actually apply. And here is a very simple, a way of looking at this model. You start with the population at time t, and suppose over a time interval delta t, population grows by delta p. So you try to find out that delta p. So what do you do? You try to find out births in time delta t, you try to find out deaths in time delta t, and try to write it. Where this c1 and c2 are the constants which tell me the growth and the decay of the population. Most of you are science students who are sitting here, I can assume that. And you know that a very similar model we applied when we were studying physics, and we wanted to understand the phenomena of radioactivity itself. So when I try to really look at this, I will find that the net decay constant actually is nothing but the difference of this C1 and C2. And I can call this as a constant C, and my equation for growth is ready. Now, this is growth if this C turns out to be positive, but it is decay if C is negative. So C1 is greater than C2, or C2 is greater than C1. We'll decide whether I'm calling it as a growth or I'm calling it as a decay. Take the time limit, you will find that an equation has emerged. dP, this is derivative of population at time t with respect to t, is equal to this. And now this is a beautiful equation. You may be wondering that why I'm using the term beauty with it. The beautiful equation is this, that this is an equation involving a function whose derivative, if I take, answer turns out to be that derivative multiplied by some constant itself. And I can give you numerous examples where this equation is involved, and you know that what will be the solution of this. We know in mathematics that there is a exponential function e raised to power x. If you take the derivative of this with respect to x itself, answer is itself the same function. So I know now what is the solution. I was in a position to solve this problem analytically, but I don't want to solve it analytically. I want to solve it numerically. So I will have to design an algorithm. So how do I design an algorithm? I go back to the previous equation. I had written it here, delta P by delta T. So what was delta P? This was nothing but this PT plus delta T minus PT, right? So that is delta P divided by delta T was also there. And on the other side, what is written? C into PT. So what I did was I converted this equation, very scary differential kind of an equation, into a very simple procedure. You give me a value of C, tell me what is today's population, and I will be able to tell you after time delta T what will be the population. Now, you have to implement it by writing a program. So what will program be? Suppose I want to see over a time interval from, say, right now, which I call as time t is equal to 0, to some time, say, t. I take the time interval delta t over which I look at the population and I draw a table. So once I draw that table, p versus pt, I can try to analyze what numbers I have got. And maybe I would like to really seek some kind of a validation process for it. Maybe I would like to go somewhere and ask somebody, can you please tell me what is the growth constant of my country? Particularly when we were, you know, talking about this epidemic, you must have been reading about these kinds of values appearing in the newspapers itself. That R value your people were talking about, you know, that how this epidemic is propagating. Believe me, and you must have read about it also, the solution of the epidemic problem is also an exponential solution. Exponential growth, exponential decay. So we wanted that somehow or the other, this growth constant, how can I control it so that population doesn't grow of the infected people? So you will find I started with a population problem, went to the epidemic problem, went to a physics problem. I find the similar equations are coming. So similar solutions will result. And that is exactly what people actually do. And it definitely involves lots of other things also, like accuracy, rate of convergence, whether numerically things are stable or not, whether my algorithm is efficient or not. I should not have an algorithm which should take too much time. Today, you know, because our computers have become very, very fast, so we are not much worried about it. We are not even much worried about the memory requirements also. But these were some very fundamental considerations which were needed by us. Even, you know, accuracy depends upon the kinds of approximations which we make. One of my professors, you know, he told me a very interesting statement about physics. He said, physics is nothing but intelligent approximations. So what are those approximations involved? Are you keeping an eye on that? And maybe somewhere when we will be doing spreadsheets, we will show you at some point of time the kinds of accuracies which we actually include when we want to solve a problem on a computer itself. Interesting thing which we should not lose sight of when we are trying to develop this kind of a computational skill. That when we go on a computer, things are not exactly represented. There are lots of manipulation of numbers which take place inside the computer which we don't know. For example, it has to convert our digital numbers, I mean, the decimal numbers into the numbers of the computer 0 and 1 binary system. And in the process of that itself, we find there are lots of things which happen on the way. And what we get in the computer ultimately, which is in binary form, is not the same number with which we started. Then there are certain round of errors which may occur. My number after calculation was too long. Computer said, truncate it. I can't hold it in my memory. So those kinds of things may also happen. So we need to keep an eye on that.
So rates of convergence is when will things converge? For example, if I'm finding a root of an equation, how I can be very, very close to the answer? Because finding a root means finding a value of x, so that if I substitute that in the function whose root I wish to find, answer should be zero. Always check, answer will never be exactly zero. So can we really look for convergences? Some methods may converge, some methods may not converge. And this is particularly true about differentiation on a computer. That's very, very... There are some numerical stabilities which are involved. And sometimes our numerical instabilities can arise from the ill conditioning of the problem. Now, this vocabulary which I am floating for this group is very, very important for us to remember. And maybe, you know, how do you learn? Sometimes you learn about some kind of a word somewhere in the lecture and you start exploring about it. Fortunately, we have a lot of possibilities today right in our home to explore things without even visiting a library. You can go to Google things, and you will find that you will get some kind of an understanding. Somebody may have done it on YouTube or somewhere, etc. So we have to be very careful when we choose these numerical methods, particularly when we will be doing spreadsheets, you know, we may not worry much about it because almost everything remains transparent. And that is the beauty of writing the spreadsheet. Efficiency, less computing time, less coding effort, all these things become. And then there are other things also which come into picture. Do remember, I am a scientist, physicist, chemist, or biologist, or maybe an economist. I am not a computing professional. And the choice of the language also depends on how easily you can learn and apply it. You will find most of the times when people are working in sociology, in social sciences, you will find that they are very happy with the spreadsheets. Even in when I started exploring spreadsheets, I found, you know, all those mathematical functions which are required by me to do physics, they are already available in the environment of the spreadsheets. So we have to be very careful. And the best thing which happens within the spreadsheets is this, that it provides you very interesting graphing capability, visualization capability. And spreadsheet offers us a kind of a middle path. We are not doing hardcore coding, but still we are doing computation. Still we are arriving at certain results, which you will get by doing hardcore coding itself. So this is the reason that we are talking about this. Thing which we have to remember is an approach which is known as divide and conquer approach. So you divide your problem into small parts. Remember, whenever you want to really think about this approach is that you want to build a house. So you know that you will have to divide building of a house into small parts. Plumbing, masoning, carpentry, painting, roofing. And you know that there are separate people who will come together and will solve this problem of building a building itself. So this approach is very interesting. And don't forget this divide and conquer approach itself. Do remember, people have been using, you know, computers for sending man on moon. Most of the times when missions fail, you know, space missions, people say, oh, there was a bug in the software which was written. They are using it for drug designing. They are using it for lots of simulations. Simulations are like, you know, experiments which you are doing. Tanishtha will actually do that simulation of the pie on the computer, and that will be a wonderful exposition of how these things we actually make use of. And then data analysis. People are talking about machine learning. People are talking of statistical, you know, parameters corresponding to a particular data which we have gathered. And you will find that very good add-ins are available in the spreadsheets itself to look at all these things. So I hope it has been a slightly longish lecture, but you will appreciate what I have just stated. So what I'll do is I will go back and be with you. And maybe we will take 5 minutes break and come again for the further discussion. And any questions, you are most welcome to really ask. Please. I have set the ball rolling. Hopefully, you will appreciate. I am very happy to see that there are 40 participants now sitting. Professor Mahan must be very happy to see this number. Hopefully, they have got the message also that what we mean by this particular work. So,
thank you, sir. Any question or query regarding the lecture?
Then we can break, yes.
Yeah. So,
Let me open the chat box. Yeah. Are there any questions in the chat box? Okay. Not very many questions.
I think, sir, this is just starting, and students are just going, making their focus on the topic. So I think there is a, everything is clear that you have explained about the spreadsheet, and you explained only the importance or the power of the spreadsheet. So I think there is no question is on this type of discussion. But there are queries and other. I can say that I didn't find the word. Students are finding a demonstration of a spreadsheet. How we can?
Oh, yeah,
so then there will be some questions also.
We will definitely do that. Ultimately, you know, this is a kind of an introduction.
Yeah.
My focus was that I must remind people in this particular lecture that new education policy is very much talking about all these things. And they should not take it as a small, you know, workshop, which was just a kind of an event, and forget about it. This is a kind of a motivational workshop also, that now you will have to deal with the computational skills also. Even if you carry a computational skill set with you somewhere, people will welcome you, even if it is working on a spreadsheet.
So, another point I want to add here is what my guy, I want to say that if we speak in easy understandable language, but for me it will be Hindi, or I don't say Punjabi, but I sometimes or some कई बार ऐसा होता है कि आपको वो सूटेबल वर्ड नहीं मिलता, आप अपने एक्सप्रेशंस को देयर इज अ रिलक्टेंस अमंग द ऑडियंस और द माय स्टूडेंट्स एज फॉर एज माय केस इज कंसर्न्ड आई समटाइम डोंट फाइंड द सूटेबल वर्ड टू से
वर्ड ना मिले तो हम हिंदी में पंजाबी में जिस
भी कहना चाहता हूँ अपने जो पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं आप उसको ये लैंग्वेज की बात को हटा के आपके माइंड में जो भी क्वेश्चन आ रहा है यू शुड से डायरेक्टली डोंट रिलक्टेंट अबाउट टेकिंग बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस इवेंट वी शुड स्पीक इन एनी लैंग्वेज आप किसी भी लैंग्वेज में पूछ सकते हैं आपका जो भी ताकि इस इवेंट का ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा फायदा हो पाए तो मेरा तो यही मानना है तो अगर आप ये सोचते रहेंगे कि अगर मैंने ये इसके लिए मुझे वर्ड नहीं मिला तो कैसे पूछूं तो आप किसी भी लैंग्वेज में पूछ सकते हो तो सर एक बात और थी तो एक सर हमने इसमें व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप क्रिएट किया है ताकि हम 24/7 फॉर द 7 डेज वी शुड कनेक्ट विद ईच अदर इफ देयर इज एनी डिफिकल्टी टू स्टूडेंट्स दे कैन डायरेक्टली सेंड इट वेरी इन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप वी विल आंसर अकॉर्डिंगली एंड And we have also created Google Classroom. So many of the students are aware of about the Google Classroom. If you say something about Google Classroom also, then it will be useful to those students which are not aware of the Google Classroom. Sir, your voice is not audible.
Can you talk about Google Classroom also a bit?
Yes.
Dear participants, Can we have only my mic on? Okay. Mr. Mahan, can you please switch off your mic? Because that disturbance is coming.
Sure.
Okay. So what I would like to say is Google Classroom is a great, classroom on the internet. And you can reach that classroom anytime, anywhere. That's the beauty of that classroom. और उस क्लासरूम में जो हमारा क्लासरूम होता है आम क्लासरूम उससे कहीं ज्यादा रिसोर्सेज अवेलेबल है हमारे पास ऐसे रिसोर्सेज इस सेंस में भी हैं कि अगर प्रोफेसर मान ये लेक्चर रिकॉर्ड कर रहे थे तो ये आपको उस गूगल क्लासरूम में दोबारा से मिल जाएगा और आमतौर पे हम ना विद्यार्थियों के लिए मैं विशेष करके बोलूंगा हम ना काफी कंप्लेसेंट हो जाते हैं काफी हम ये कहते हैं लेक्चर तो सुनी लेंगे वो तो अवेलेबल हो जाएगा गूगल क्लासरूम में तो बहुत गड़बड़ होती है उसमें हमें ये ध्यान रखना चाहिए कि जो लेक्चर हम सुन रहे हैं अगर उसको दोबारा सुनना पड़ेगा तो उतना ही टाइम फिर दोबारा आपको लगाना पड़ेगा तो आप देख लीजिए कि आप इतना टाइम लगाना चाहते हो दोबारा इट्स नॉट एडवाइजेबल टू स्पेंड सो मच टाइम राइट सो आप लेक्चर सुनो, हाँ उस लेक्चर में आप बहुत मजबूरी हो जाए तो जाकर के उसको देख सकते हो, पर्टिकुलरली जब हम डेमोज वगैरह करेंगे तो उन डेमोज को करने के लिए आप यूज कर सकते हो। मैं आपको एक बात खास बताना चाहता हूँ, हम YouTube कैसे इस्तेमाल करते हैं लर्निंग के लिए। हम क्या करते हैं, एक विंडो में YouTube खोल लेते हैं, कुछ बोलने लगता है YouTube वाला, वो जो कुछ कर रहा होता है हम एक पॉज बटन पे चले जाते हैं और फिर दोबारा से अपनी विंडो में आकर के वो जो बोल रहा था उसको करके देख लेते हैं। अगर हम सेटिस्फाई हो जाते हैं देन वी गो बैक टू द YouTube अगेन, उसको स्टार्ट करके आगे सुनना शुरू कर लेते हैं। दिस इज वॉट वी डू। आप सच मानो हमारी लर्निंग ऐसे ही हुई है, हमें किसी ने नहीं पढ़ाया, ऐसे ही तुक्के तक्के मार के पढ़ने की कोशिश करी हमने। सो प्लीज रिमेम्बर दैट यू आर वेरी फॉर्चुनेट, आपको गूगल क्लासरूम में असाइनमेंट्स मिल जाती हैं, स्ट्रीमिंग हो जाती है उसमें, उसमें बैठ करके आप अपने साथियों के साथ डायलॉग कर सकते हो, आप क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हो जो आपको लेक्चर के बाद कभी ख्याल में आए कि ये क्वेश्चन तो मेरा था मैंने पूछा नहीं, चलो मैं ऐसा करता हूँ एक क्वेश्चन डाल देता हूँ गूगल क्लासरूम में, तो सर शायद जा करके देख लेंगे और उसका उत्तर दे देंगे। तो ये सारी पॉसिबिलिटीज और सारा कुछ जो मजेदार है, देखो आप मुझे नजर नहीं आ रहे हो, आपने सबने अपने अपने जो कैमरे हैं वो ऑफ करे हुए हैं। हम लोग टीचरों को बड़ी आदत होती है कि क्लास में देखते रहते हैं कोई बच्चा सिर हिला रहा है या नहीं हिला रहा है। थैंक यू मैम सर मिस्टर एंड कुलविंदर जी, एटलीस्ट आई एम एबल टू सी दैट समबडी इज नॉडिंग दैट ओके कुछ बन रही है बात। तो ये सारी बातें आप ध्यान में रखो और एक आप तो 21वीं सदी के बच्चे हो, अगर मैं विद्यार्थियों से बात करूं आपको बहुत कुछ लर्न करने को मिलेगा। ये डिपेंड करता है कि हम कितना कुछ इस्तेमाल कर पाते हैं, चीजें तो बहुत लंबी चौड़ी हैं, मुझे जितनी जरूरत है अगर वो मैं इस्तेमाल कर पाऊं वो मेरी सक्सेस स्टोरी का हिस्सा बनती है। और मेरे को भी कुछ ज्यादा नहीं आती है स्प्रेडशीट, या ये मत या समझना कि मुझे मैं को बहुत बड़ा एक्सपर्ट हूं। मैंने अभी आपसे एक अपने लेक्चर में बात की, वो क्या बात की कि भाई मैं मेरे पास बड़ी चॉइसेस थी, सी सी प्लस प्लस पाइथन ये वो फोर सब सीखना शुरू कर लो। मैंने अपने आप को रिस्ट्रिक्ट किया कि जब मुझे कंप्यूटेशनल स्किल की जरूरत है तो मैं जरूरत को कैसे इस्तेमाल करूं और कौन सी चीज मुझे क्विक रिजल्ट्स दे। ये ना हो कि मैं न्यूमेरिकल मेथड ही बच्चों को पढ़ाता रहा और फिजिक्स टच ही ना कराऊं। मेरी ये बड़ी चिंता थी कि भाई दिन पहले दिन से बच्चा फिजिक्स टच करना शुरू करे। एंड स्प्रेडशीट इज वन सच प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर यू विल फाइंड, आप मेरे से बात करो या ना करो अपने आप फिजिक्स एक्सप्लोर करना शुरू कर। तो सर मैंने बोल दिया।
सर एक बात और थी, जो कल का आपका सर जो लेक्चर है उसके लिए कोई रिक्वायरमेंट हो तो बच्चों को आप थोड़ा सा बता सकते हो, तो ये वो देखे हैं और पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं और बच्चों को ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड सम टीचर्स आर आल्सो देयर सॉरी टू से।
व्हाट दे कैन डू इज दे कैन गो स्विच ऑन एक्सेल शीट, उनको कुछ ना कुछ उसमें आता ही होगा। हम ये मान के चल रहे हैं कि जो हमारे सामने ये 40 पार्टिसिपेंट्स बैठे हुए हैं ये ऐसे नहीं है कि उनको कुछ आता नहीं है, उनका कहीं ना कहीं एक्सपोजर है, बट हमारा एक व्यू पॉइंट है जो हम देंगे स्प्रेडशीट्स के बारे में। एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई कॉल्ड माय टुडेज लेटर पार्ट ऑफ द लेक्चर एज स्प्रेडशीट एज अ किलर एप्लीकेशन, और उसको मैं ट्यून करूंगा कि मैं फिजिक्स के लिए कैसे उसको इस्तेमाल करूंगा, मेरी फिजिक्स की नीड्स उसमें कैसे फुलफिल होंगी। आई होप आई एम एबल टू मेक सम पॉइंट क्लियर। आप अगर अपने कंप्यूटर पे बैठ सकते हो, लैपटॉप पे बैठ सकते हो, बड़ी अच्छी बात है अगर आप कर लो, और वो छोटी छोटी प्रॉब्लम है पर्टिकुलरली टू द स्टूडेंट्स। एंड प्रोफेसर सपना शर्मा इज गोइंग टू कम, उन्होंने UGC का जो कंप्यूटेशनल फिजिक्स का कोर्स है उसमें जो एक्सरसाइजेस दे रखी हुई है, और वो एक्सरसाइजेस भी ऐसी हैं जो पर्टिकुलरली फिजिक्स के लिए नहीं है, वो कोई भी स्टूडेंट चाहे वो इकोनॉमिक्स का है या चाहे वो केमिस्ट्री का है वो उन एक्सरसाइजेस को कर सकता है और लर्न कर सकता है। इवन सोशल साइंसेज वाले भी वो एक्सरसाइजेस छोटी छोटी कर सकते हैं। Is that clear, sir?
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
तो मैं 5 मिनट के लिए ब्रेक करूंगा और मेरे पास फिर भी कितना टाइम है, 12-14 मिनट है, तो बात करने की कोशिश करूंगा। Is it possible to break for 5 minutes?
Sure, sir. Sure. Hello. For all the participants, I think I don't want to bore you. So, Dr. P.K. Ahluwalia ji has explained about the beauty of spreadsheets in a very beautiful way. So he explained, he compared the population growth with the radioactivity, giving the example of the derivative of a function, and he explained the rate of increase of money with the help of derivative. And he also explained the exponential function to describe the growth of this epidemic and the decay of this epidemic. And by using the modeling, and we defined physics in a different way. The physics is nothing but an intelligent approximation. So he also described that the spreadsheet is not a hard coding. It is just like a middle path. So layman can use these spreadsheets to solve their problems and to do their computations. So during this break, I want to explain about spreadsheet that I know and that I have used it for my computations. Spreadsheet is a beautiful tool that I am the fan of this spreadsheet, or I say it as Excel made me Excel also. So in any field, so I have completed my MSc from Pebble University Patiala, and during my second year of MSc, we do Fortran programming. So in comparison, I am not against the Fortran programming, but if I compare Fortran program or C program with this Excel or spreadsheet, then spreadsheet is much, much, much easier than any programming that I have read till today. So in spreadsheet, it is, every step is visible to you or transparent to you what is going on in this step. You can take the steps and you see what is going on. And you can do any type of calculation, scientific calculation, trigonometric calculation, integration, differentiation, everything is possible with the help of a spreadsheet. So but the second beauty of the spreadsheet is that you can plot any graph. You can plot graph of the variables. You can, if you change the variable, you see the change in the graph and in that level. So I am not more in my mind to explain about to tell about the spreadsheet. I want to share my screen to show about some demonstration, or we will wait to be careful on this. So I think we should take some break of 1 or 2 minutes. So wait, don't leave this group. So till Aluvalia sir will come back. If any query or two questions or the mind which hai, jo participants hai gaya, sound not clear. Mujhe awaaz nahi aa rahi keh rahe hain. So I think of Mr. Man is there. Yes, sir. Welcome back.
Okay, fine. So now we will go to the other presentation. I mean, this we will continue next tomorrow also. Don't worry about it. Part of it I will introduce, because I treat this program as a highly motivational kind of a program, and those motivations should remain with us. If we lose motivation, I think usme bahut gadbad hogi. Main chahta hu jitne yahan pe participants hain, they should feel that they are part of this learning process and not something. So kuch motivation ki baat hum zarur karte rahenge beech beech mein. So let me once again share my screen and come back to the next presentation. So now I will go into the nitty-gritty of the spreadsheets. Or agar aapke paas spreadsheet hai Excel ki ya koi aur spreadsheet bhi, so please believe me, there are very many common things which are there in all spreadsheet. Menus are almost now standard, so you don't need to really worry about this. But the best part of it is that how spreadsheets use. So what is a spreadsheet? It is nothing but an electronic version of a traditional page of a bookkeeper's account book. वो जो लालों का बही खाता होता था ना, जिसमें लाइनें लगा के और कॉलम लगा के वो रोज लिखते थे, आज फलानी तारीख को ये माल लिया, इतने पैसे हुए. That kind of an account book it is. But it is a very big spreadsheet. It's a huge spreadsheet. It is an electronic version of that. And the difference is this: पहले जो अकाउंटेंट होता था उसको सारी बुक कीपिंग खुद करनी पड़ती थी. अगर आपको मंडियों में तो मिल जाएंगे, एपीएमसी में बैठे हुए मिल जाते हैं मुनीम, अगर आप देखोगे तो उनकी पीठ भी जो है वो झुक जाती थी, इतना काम उनको करना पड़ता था. एंड दिस स्प्रेडशीट हैज गॉट एन इनविजिबल असिस्टेंट जो आपको मौके मौके पे हेल्प करता रहेगा, एंड इट विल फ्री यू फ्रॉम ड्रजरी ऑफ द लेबोरियस एंड रेपिटेटिव वर्क. जैसे इमेजिन करो उस अकाउंटेंट के खाते में एक जगह कहीं एंट्री में गलती होगी,
तो सारी कैलकुलेशन उसको दोबारा से करनी पड़ती थी एंड दैट वॉज वेरी वेरी लेबोरियस काइंड ऑफ ए टास्क एंड दीज काइंड ऑफ लेबोरियस रेपिटेटिव टास्क दिस इनविजिबल असिस्टेंट इज एबल टू टेक केयर फॉर अस सो स्प्रेडशीट इज नथिंग बट ए कंप्यूटर प्रोग्राम विच कन्वर्ट्स कंप्यूटर स्क्रीन इन टू ए स्मार्ट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स पेपर हैविंग ए कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ रीयूजेबिलिटी प्लीज डू रिमेंबर दिस रीयूजेबिलिटी इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म आप देखोगे जब आप न्यूमेरिकल कंप्यूटेशन करना शुरू करोगे स्प्रेडशीट की मदद से अगर आपने एक स्प्रेडशीट बना ली है तो उसी स्प्रेडशीट को दोबारा से आप कॉपी करके उसमें चेंजेस करके एक नई स्प्रेडशीट बना सकते हो दैट इज व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द रीयूजेबिलिटी सो इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ ए रीसाइक्लिंग प्रोसेस नथिंग गोज वेस्ट यू कैन यूज इट अगेन एंड अगेन बाय द पर्पस टू विच यू वॉन्ट टू एक्चुअली पुट इट एंड वॉट इट इज इफ यू लुक एट इट इज लाइक ए मैट्रिक्स इज एन एरे ऑफ रोज एंड कॉलम्स with automatic update facility and capability and display capability. And this capability has been extended as far as sciences are concerned by means of libraries of mathematical and statistical functions. Versatile graphing and charting facility with a highly functional graphical user interface. बहुत सुंदर graph इस पे बनते हैं और मैं तो ये समझता हूँ यहाँ पे बैठे हुए जितने भी विद्यार्थी हैं future में जब भी आप lab में जाओ आपको sir बोले कि experiment करने के बाद ये चीजें जो आपने रीडिंग्स दे रखी है इनके ग्राफ बनाओ तो आपने अब दोबारा से ग्राफ पेपर नहीं टच करना है आपने स्प्रेडशीट के ऊपर ही ग्राफ बनाना है एंड आई थिंक दैट विल बी ए वंडरफुल वे टू बिकम कंफर्टेबल ऑन द कंप्यूटर इटसेल्फ और इसकी हिस्ट्री डेवलपमेंट की बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग है एक मैनेजमेंट का स्टूडेंट था उसका नाम था डैन ब्रिकलिन उसने ये कंसेप्ट एक्चुअली उसके दिमाग में आया उसको जरूरत थी अपने रिसर्च में करने के लिए और उसके पास उस वक्त एप्पल टू प्लेटफॉर्म था और जाकर के उसने अपनी यूनिवर्सिटी में कंप्यूटर सेंटर के प्रोग्रामर से बात की बॉब फ्रैंकस्टन के साथ कि भाई ऐसे ऐसे मेरे को आइडिया आ रहा है और मुझे इसकी ज़रूरत है तो कुछ हम मिलके कुछ कर सकते हैं कंसेप्ट मेरे पास है आप प्रोग्रामर हो मैं आपको समझा देता हूँ आप देखिए यहाँ पे व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कंसेप्ट द मीनिंग ऑफ कंसेप्ट इज दैट दिस फेलो हैड द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम ही हैड द मॉडल वाया विच ही वॉन्टेड टू वर्क वॉट ही वॉज लैकिंग वॉज द कंप्यूटेशनल स्किल So he went to that programmer and he said, can you please help me to create this kind of a form? And that is exactly what happened. And that is where this single application was able to create millions of Apple II computer users. Apple II bikai tab, jab is kisam ka hame software uspe mil gaya. Aur ye jo Bob aur Don Dan the, inhone mil karke ek software company banai. Uska naam rakha Software Art to market the product. Aur phir inhone ye नाम दिया था इसको विजी कैल्क देखिए नाम कितना इंटरेस्टिंग है जो कैलकुलेशन होती है वो सामने आपको नजर आती है एंड दैट इज वेयर आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अंडरलाइन इट जब आप कोई कंप्यूटर प्रोग्राम लिखते हो और आपने लिख लिया उसके बाद अगर आप उसको समझना चाहते हो कि विजुअलाइज करना चाहते हो तो वो विजुअलाइजेशन इतनी ईजी नहीं है और इसीलिए बहुत एम्फेसिस देते हैं प्रोग्राम कोडिंग करने वाले लोग कि भाई डॉक्यूमेंटेशन प्रॉपर करो अपने प्रोग्राम में ताकि आपको नजर आता रहे वॉट लाइन मीन्स वॉट अदरवाइज यू विल नेक्स्ट टाइम वेल यू कम to this program after 6 months, you may not know what this program is actually doing. So this VisiCalc actually keeps everything transparent. And that is why I am saying spreadsheet is a middle path. और उन्होंने इसको Lotus एक company है उसको बेचा और उन्होंने एक नई spreadsheet develop की उसका नाम था Lotus 1-2-3 और ये Lotus 1-2-3 में जो 1-2-3 का मतलब है ना ये वैसे ही है जैसे कोई हमें indication देता है रेस में जाने के लिए और आपने देखा होगा कि बंदूक चलाने से पहले वो आदमी बोलता है 1-2-3 एंड गो और वो पिस्टल चला देता है जाने के लिए सो दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ रेस विच यू कुड रन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस सॉफ्टवेयर एंड इट वाज स्पेसिफिकली मेड फॉर आईबीएम पीसी एप्पल के लिए नहीं था एंड इट हैज बीन वन ऑफ द फाउंडिंग फादर्स ऑफ द पर्सनल कंप्यूटर्स एंड इट इज अ टूल फॉर लाइफ आई एम अंडरलाइनिंग दिस वर्ड टूल फॉर लाइफ जब मैं लास्ट स्लाइड पे पहुंचूंगा तो मैं आपको इसके बारे में बताने की कोशिश करूंगा वॉट कैन यू डू ऑन ए स्प्रेडशीट सवाल आमतौर पर हमें आते हैं ग्राफ बना सकते हैं डाटा को सॉर्ट कर सकते हैं जैसे मैं टीचर हूँ टेस्ट लेता हूँ कौन फर्स्ट है कौन सेकेंड है कौन थर्ड है वो डाटा मैंने मैनेज करना है आई कैन डू दैट कौन फर्स्ट आ रहा है कौन सेकेंड आ रहा है ग्रेडिंग करनी है फाइल कॉम्बिनेशन फैसिलिटीज है कोई डाटा कहीं पड़ा हुआ है ला करके इसमें मैं कंबाइन कर सकता हूँ देख सकते मैथमेटिकल और स्टेटिस्टिकल फंक्शंस को मैं इसमें ग्राफिक कर सकता हूँ इम्पोर्ट डाटा कर सकता हूँ एक्सपोर्ट डाटा कर सकता हूँ टू डिफरेंट रिसोर्सेज एंड we have possibility of I would like to underline instantaneous numerical simulations isme ye ek jagah parameter badla ekdam aapko nazar aa jayega baki jagah pe kya kya asar hua for example agar aapki spreadsheet mein आपने एक जगह पे चार्ट बनाया हुआ है और आपने कोई पैरामीटर चेंज किया, आपको पता लगेगा उस चार्ट में भी चेंजेस होंगे. सो फंक्शन टेबुलेशन एंड प्लॉटिंग, इंटीग्रेशन, मैट्रिसेस, इन्वर्जन, लीनियर अलजेब्रिक इक्वेशंस आपको सॉल्व करनी है तो बहुत एडिंग्स अवेलेबल है हम लोग. और वो एडिंग्स क्या है, सॉल्वर है फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ये मैनेजमेंट वाले लोग इसको बहुत यूज करते हैं. क्वेरीज अवेलेबल है, एनालिसिस टूल पैक्स अवेलेबल है, स्टैटिस्टिकल एनालिसिस टूल पैक्स आर अवेलेबल टू अस. तो हमें चाहिए क्या स्प्रेडशीट बनाने की, एंड दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. नंबर वन, यू शुड डेवलप एब्स्ट्रैक्ट रीजनिंग. मैंने जब आपको पिछला लेक्चर दिया तो उसमें मैंने आपको बताया कि वो जो पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ की प्रॉब्लम थी उसको कैसे मैंने मैथमेटिक्स में कन्वर्ट करा. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ ए रीजनिंग यू नीड टू रियली हैव. और अलजेब्रा एक्चुअली प्रोवाइड्स अस दैट काइंड ऑफ ए प्लेटफॉर्म टू थिंक, एंड दैट इज देयर स्किल फॉर मैथमेटिकल थिंकिंग एक्चुअली कम्स इनटू प्ले. ये जो हमारा न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी है, नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी 2020 बोल रही है. सेकेंडली, हमने कहा था वो जो मैंने फोर स्टेप्स आपको बताए थे, वो कौन से रूल्स हैं या कौन से लॉज हैं जिनको आप टूल्स की तरह इस्तेमाल करोगे और अपनी स्प्रेडशीट में एक रूल मेकर की तरह आप बन जाओगे. ये वाला रूल लगा तो मेरे क्या आंसर्स आ रहे हैं, रूल में मैंने कुछ चेंज करी तो मेरे आंसर्स कैसे चेंज हो रहे हैं. एंड इट ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड्स अस ए काइंड ऑफ ए अपॉर्चुनिटी इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन ओपन एंडेड इन्वेस्टिगेशन, जैसे वॉट इफ काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन, अगर ऐसे हो तो क्या हो, मैं अपनी दुकान पे 50 कुर्सियां और 50 टेबल बनाऊं, या 50 कुर्सियां और 200 टेबल बनाऊं, या मैं 50 टेबल और 200 कुर्सियां बनाऊं, क्या करूं, ऐसे क्वेश्चन मुझे पूछने. एंड सडनली यू विल फाइंड दैट इट बिकम्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग प्रॉब्लम ओरिएंटेड एक्टिविटी एंड स्टूडेंट्स बिकम एक्टिव लर्नर्स. आई वुड लाइक टू रियली अंडरलाइन दिस आस्पेक्ट ऑल्सो दैट यू बिकम एक्टिव लर्नर्स. आई थिंक वी विल स्टॉप हियर. ये एक अच्छा पॉइंट है जहां पे हम रुक सकते हैं और हम यहाँ से कल अपना लेक्चर स्टार्ट करेंगे और कुछ मैं आपको डेमोज भी दूंगा और वो मैं प्रोग्राम भी जो हमने बनाए हैं स्प्रेडशीट्स वो आपके साथ क्लासरूम में शेयर भी करूंगा. आई होप दैट इज क्वाइट जस्टिफाइड.
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच. सो हेलो, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच. एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू मार्क देयर अटेंडेंस. I have shared a link in the chat box. You click on this link and type your name and type this code. The code is online workshop OW27. So you can make your attendance. We have to monitor this the sincerity or the continuity in next 6 days. So for this, I have designed this Google form for checking that all the students or the participants remain present in all the 6 days. So, and I want to thank to all the source persons, Dr. P.K. Aluwalia ji, Smita ma'am, Sapna Sharma ma'am, and all the participants to be with us in this first day of the workshop. Thank you very much.
So I want to thank Ma'am Sarvishta and Professor Sapna that they are there, and I hope we will have great time in this workshop.
Yeah, just 1 minute. It would be nice if the students switch on their videos and at least tell one word whether they have understood anything, whether they are able to follow, do they know how to use an Excel spreadsheet. If we know, then we can proceed better tomorrow. Because they are keeping quiet, we really don't know what they have understood about. So, Hindi mein bolne dijiye unko, jo bhi man karta hai, ek ek sentence batayenge. एक सेंटेंस आधा वर्ड बताएंगे, उनका फीडबैक लेने से हमें पता चलेगा क्या करना चाहिए.
एक बहुत अच्छा क्वेश्चन आया है, नेहा गंडोत्रा है, उन्होंने क्वेश्चन पूछा है, सर हाउ कैन इट बी यूज्ड इन केमिस्ट्री और इट इज यूज्ड इन जस्ट डाटा मैनेजमेंट लाइक इन अकाउंट और इन अदर वे. नेहा जी, आर यू देयर, आप हो यहाँ पे, प्लीज जरा अपना चेहरा दिखा दो.
नेहा,
नेहा जी आप हो? ओह या, ये नेहा जी आपने बहुत अच्छा सवाल किया है. आई थिंक आप मुझे ध्यान से सुन रहे होंगे और आपने जरूर भी एक बात सुनी होगी कि ये सिर्फ फिजिक्स वालों के लिए नहीं है या सिर्फ ये मैनेजमेंट वालों के लिए नहीं है, ये किसी के लिए भी है. आपके पास प्रॉब्लम होनी चाहिए और आप देखोगे कि हम कैसे इसमें अपनी मैथमेटिकल स्किल्स को इस्तेमाल करेंगे प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करने के लिए.
और क्या क्या चीजें हमको स्प्रेडशीट्स पे अवेलेबल है. ये बहुत बड़ा बॉक्स है जिसमें बहुत सारे टूल्स पड़े हुए हैं. आपको जैसे जैसे टूल्स पता लगने लगेंगे आप चीजें एंजॉय करने लगोगे. अच्छा ये भी है इसमें, इसमें ये भी है. जैसे मैंने आपको बोला मैथमेटिकल फंक्शंस अवेलेबल है. तो अगर आप कोई मान लीजिए मैथमेटिक्स करना चाहते हो फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री में, लेट मी गो टू फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री का एग्जाम्पल हम ले लेते हैं. आप रेट ऑफ इक्वेशन स्टडी करना चाहते हो तो यू विल फाइंड कि इन स्प्रेडशीट्स के ऊपर वो एनालिसिस आप बड़े आराम से कर सकते हो. तो ये एक आपने केमिस्ट्री में न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स वाला पार्ट पढ़ते हो जिसको आप न्यूक्लियर केमिस्ट्री बोलते हो, हम उसको न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स बोल देते हैं. तो आपने उसको बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग वे में यूज करते हो आप. तो वो जो चीजें हैं उनके जो लॉज हैं वो आप उनको एक्सप्लोर कर सकते हो. इवन नॉट ओनली दैट, अगर आप चाहो ना तो आप बड़े इंटरेस्टिंग वे में स्प्रेडशीट पे अपनी ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री को कंडेंस करके एक स्प्रेडशीट में लिख सकते हो कि जब भी रेडी रिएक्टर की तरह मुझे कुछ अपनी ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री देखनी है तो मेरी एक रेडी रिएक्टर की तरह स्प्रेडशीट मेरे पास पड़ी हुई है, उसको मैं देख लूंगा. क्लासिफिकेशंस कर सकता हूं मैं चीजों की बड़े आराम से. तो ये छोटी छोटी चीजें हैं जो आप कर सकते हो. नेहा जी मैं एक आपको और बात बताना चाहता हूँ. मैं वैसे फिजिक्स वाला हूँ, पिछले कुछ वर्षों में मैंने जो काम किया है ना वो केमिस्ट्री वाले भी करते हैं और वो केमिस्ट्री वाले वही चीजें इस्तेमाल करते हैं. मैंने भी सेम काम किया
है. इसका मतलब है काफी कुछ कॉमन है. डोंट वरी अबाउट इट, आपको काफी कुछ इसमें सीखने को मिलेगा. If we make some simple program in it.
Ishani, where are you? Can you please show your face? Ishani, how are you? Don't switch it off, keep it on. Shivani, keep it on. Your face, we would like to really see. Okay. I think, sir, students have started asking questions. That is a very good sign.
Thank you, sir. Actually, students or participants, please introduce 1 minute about yourself and explain as Mr. Ma'am has gestured to you whether you gain something or what type of information you want to take from this workshop too, so that we can plan our future lectures accordingly.
If you have a data, you can always get that in a file and you can always import that. You don't need to type down. Tab to phir on karega spreadsheet jisse bahar agar hame yehi karna pad jaye. Wahan pe import facilities available hai hamare paas. अमृता जी आपने बहुत जबरदस्त क्वेश्चन पूछा. फिर तो मैं फेंक दूंगा सारे काम को, फेंक दूंगा. मैं तो बोलूंगा अभी मुझे ये नहीं करना है, अगर मुझे फिर दोबारा से टाइपिंग करनी पड़ेगी. आप स्प्रेडशीट से वर्ड में ले जा सकते हो, वर्ड से स्प्रेडशीट में ला सकते हो, टेबल्स को ले ला सकते हो. वो सारी पॉसिबिलिटीज है. वेरी गुड. सो आई थिंक लुविंदर जी वी कैन स्टॉप हियर.
Thank you very much for sparing your valuable time, and all the participants are requested to join well in time tomorrow. So thank you.